Zach Maslany now making his way to the stage. Maslany in the black and white. 6666, expect fireworks, ladies and gentlemen.
Yes. It's Zach from 10th Planet Bethlehem.
10th Planet Bethlehem.
Veritable dream to my killers.
Him and JM,
yes,
holding down the fort at 10th Planet Bethlehem.
Great technique.
He's a beast. He's a savage.
Excellent coaches, I have to say. Great guys, JM and Zach.
That's a beautiful.
Great guys, JM and Zach.
Veritable dream to my killers.
He's a beast. He's a savage.
It's Zach from 10th Planet Bethlehem.
10th Planet Bethlehem. That's 10th Planet Bethlehem. That's a bit.
Great technique.
It's 10th Planet Bethlehem.
It's a Zach's Corner podcast.
Blowing niggas with rusty ass German things, giving the double as I motherfucking claim the fame. Throwing your wetsuit when it rains and pours and all. Hit them with the fall, don't even know me from a hole in the wall. Get at me, niggas wanna clap me, slips wanna rap me, put it right where they back me. Keep my guns close to me, enemies even closer. Send the kites with the Motorola's, yeah. Give them the cold shoulder with a hollow tip to match. Bad apple out of the bat, success with gas. Since a little too eating niggas full up 50s. Niggas can kill me, but they coming with me. How about that? Send the queen bee to attack. Only your fly bitch like that can leave her relax. Rockin' to sleep, make them think the drama is dead. Yo, I smile up in your face, go on fightin' instead.
Yo, it's some real shit, shit to make you feel shit. Dump them in the club, shit. Have you out and out when you bump this. Love to your eardrum, the war uncut. Have a nigga OD, cause it's never enough. Yo, it's the real shit, shit to make you feel shit. Dump them in the club, shit. Have you out and out when you bump this. Love to your eardrum, the war uncut. Have a nigga OD, cause it's never enough. Hot damn,
ho,
here we go again. Like
this
a rock, bitch, hard as a
cop. Whoa! What up? It's the Zach's Corner Podcast, Volume 40. What up, everybody? Like a radio host. What's going on, guys? Man, 2019 is over. That shit has come to a close. We survived it, guys. If you're listening to this right now, you've survived 2019. And also, you're part of the resistance. You know, you're on the team. We're doing this. We're on the fringe. You know what I'm saying? It's the Zach's Corner Podcast. My buddy Sean, who's he's a comedian and he lives in California. I know I talk about him a lot, but you know, he's one of the guys that since he moved out to California was one of the reasons why I was able to get into 10th Planet. And we would always do that joke. Like he actually gave me idea to do this podcast because back in the day, he was the first ever person I knew that had a podcast. And it was called The Sean Green Show, I think. And then it was an actual show. And then he started doing a podcast. Just trying to get his name out there and just try to put out content. And we did a couple at my house, at my old place. And then he would call me from California and I would answer the phone and I would do like a hometown, I guess, you know, like a review of what's going on at home. And I would just talk to him about like random stupid shit. And then I also made a couple of crank phone calls when he had guests on. And he would open up the phone lines. I would call in. I think I actually spoke with, so one of the prank phone calls that I did is I called in. He had Nick Cage's brother on. I don't know. Let's look this up. I wonder if that's on, wonder if I have that audio clip anywhere. But Nick Cage's brother is named Christopher Coppola. And that's who was on. Yeah, if you just... I know you can't see this, but if you look up Christopher Coppola, Francis Ford Coppola he directed The Godfather, I believe, and his two sons, like Francis Ford Coppola, let's look, Apocalypse Now, Godfather, let's see, we can look up else about him, his Wikipedia, and he wrote The Godfather and all this stuff, and then his son's children, Giancarlo Coppola, Roman Coppola, Sofia Coppola. Somehow Nicolas Cage is his nephew. Okay. So then maybe Francis Ford Coppola. We talked to one of these guys. I don't know. Nicolas Cage. Let's look up him. But anyways, I called in and I acted like, it doesn't say he has any brothers. Maybe, damn, he's got a couple of spouses though. Nicolas Cage is hilarious. But I called in, maybe it was his cousin or maybe it was a stepbrother or some shit like that. But anyways, I called in and acted like the guy was Nicolas Cage. And I asked him two stupid questions. I think I was like, I asked him about the the dinosaur skull or something that he bought. I forget. I'll try to get that audio for you guys. But yeah, so Sean, why was I telling the story again? I'm sure I'll remember once I get going. But man, is my memory that bad? I got to start taking ginkgo biloba. Oh, Sean, he was one of the guys who got me into 10th Planet because he moved out to California. And then he, you know, I started going out to visit him and being able to train with Eddie and all types of stuff. But he's the one who got me into podcasts because he started a podcast. Like I said, he was the first one I ever knew to start a podcast. And then, you know, he just kept it going. And now they have the sports gambling podcast. So if you're into gambling on sports, mainly like football stuff, baseball, basketball, that, go to the sports gambling podcast and check that out. I should use them as one of my sponsors. But yeah, he's the one who got me into podcasts too, which is really cool. And I'm excited to continue to do this. We just put out a finishers podcast, so if you're bored, go on and check that. I know I'm super late on this, but I wanted to do like a 2019 review, and nothing crazy, but just go over some of the highlights of my 2019. Not that you guys give a shit, but in case you did, right, I'll talk about it anyways because that's what this podcast is for. Right. And I learned a lot in 2019. I think, like, you know, people are always like, oh man, like, you know, whatever, it was just another year. What, screw it, you know? But if you like break it down, like if you did like, oh, this half of the year was good, like a lot of people like to break things down and statistics and all this stuff. And like, hey, this is what I did this year. This is what I did that year. Like, people love doing those face apps. This is what I look like back then. This is what I look like now. Oh, this is what I look like if I was an old person. And they, you know, you break it up and, oh, this was my decade, or, you know, but what, even though that is corny and shit, but whatever you got to do to get yourself pumped up to either work out and get in shape or start a business or quit your job and do your own thing or whatever the situation is, whatever you got to do. If it's a new year thing, do it. And then even though it's corny, new year, new me, stick with it though. If you can stick with it, that would be awesome. Like, we got me and JM got a lot of big things coming up. So we've been training hard at the school. Same with Thor. And, you know, I'm getting my ass in shape because I'm doing this team tournament thing. You know, JM was going to do it, but then he's coming back from Iceland that day. So I'm stepping up and jumping on a team. And, you know, I'm not going to lie, guys, this is probably going to be one of the last times I compete. So if you're listening to this, you want to come watch me compete, that would be dope. It's only $20 to get in. Grace has a big match against Trinity Pun. Bryant from the school's got a match. Will's on the card. Like, it's going to be dope. So I'm really pumped up. It's a Sunday. It's at Matrix Performance Strength and Conditioning Gym near Zombie Jiu-Jitsu off Union Boulevard in Allentown. Should be really dope. But but I'm stepping it up. 2020. I'm like, fuck it. New year. Let's go. Let's get in shape. Let's, you know, train hard and, you know, show the students what it's like to be training hard and, you know, put the guys on and, you know, lead from the front. Like, I'm going to be facing a lot of tough dudes, dude. It's going to be crazy. You know, who knows what's going to happen, but at least if we win two, I'm going to get at least 2 8-minute matches. So I'm making sure I'm in shape, son. What else is it? Anyways, 2019. So, and like I said, I learned a lot in 2019 and I got to do a lot of cool stuff, family stuff with my wife, you know, like just going back. So 2019 right here, because I did get married the last December before the new year of 2019. So that I did have in 2019, I had my 1 year wedding anniversary, which was pretty cool. So I got to celebrate that with my wife. We went to Vermont. We drove in a snow blizzard storm where I thought I was going to die, but we didn't because I'm driving like I'm like a wheel man, just keeping steady, just being comfortable in a very uncomfortable position driving home. But we survived. Me and her also went to Colorado. That was a lot of fun. And I think that really, like, that was our best trip together. Like, that stole our hearts. Colorado is the shit. And I can't wait to go back. Like, I follow Breckenridge. And now I feel like my body is made up over the holidays of half Breckenridge Brewery beers. I like nitro beers. I'll tell you what. And I like another one. I don't know what it's called. I can't remember what the name of it is, but it's a stout or imperial stout, creme brulee. Man, those stout beers are so good. And I've said that, and maybe 20 people have said, "'Tis the season." Yeah, but I can drink stout beers whenever I want. It doesn't have to be a seasonal thing, although I really like seasonal beers. Most of them, you know. So I was out of beers for a while, and I was just drinking wine, but now I'm back into beers a little bit. So just taking a slow, just a few, though. I can't, like, you know, I don't really get drunk because I don't want to feel like shit, even though the holiday party is the one night of the year that I usually do have too many drinks. But this year, I did have too many drinks. A couple of people bought me shots. I think Morgan and Billy were buying me shots or something. Maybe it was, it's usually Mark, but I have no idea. Got to see Big Chris, too, when we were hanging out that night, which was really awesome. So, oh, and then also me and my wife also went to the Finger Lakes, which is really dope, too. So if you ever are bored and you got nothing to do with your girl, like, and you can't afford, like, a trip out to Colorado, and, you know, if you don't want to save up for it, you know, if you're in this area, drive up to the Finger Lakes. It's dope. If you like wineries, you know, we went up there when it was freezing cold. We like to go on trips when it's ice cold for some odd reason. But check that out. You know what I mean? Check out Vermont. That's drivable. The Finger Lakes is definitely drivable. So definitely do that. What else? Let's see. We, couple 10 planets, like, opened up, which was really dope in 2019. Thor was able to open up the 10 planet Allentown. We had the grand opening of that. I don't remember what the hell month that was, but man, it's so crazy. Like, me and JM, it's like totally come back around, circle of life type stuff, because me and JM opened when we first started 10 Planet was out of Team Hammer Gym at 10 Planet Allentown. So there's, like, you know, Greg and Matt and a couple of guys have 10 Planet Allentown shirts just floating around. And, you know, at the Allentown grand opening, like, I painted that place, stores, put in so much work, you know, working full-time job, you know, coming home, competing at ADCC, like, you know, working, grinding every on a weekend by fucking ceiling tiles and inspections and all types of stupid shit, getting signs put up, and then bam, it's open. I saw the other night they had a fundamentals class that was stacked. They had a lot of people in it. So it's awesome, man. It's so cool to see, like, our finisher squad expanding. And you know, I'm just trying to be on the mat every day and everything, and, you know, Thor's on the mat every day. It's awesome, you know. And at the Allentown grand opening, we were able to give Matt Clambay Cook, Greg the Hammer Henry, and Chris the Black Ninja Hendricks, all guys have been training with us since we were 10th Planet Allentown, or guys that started before we even, you know, were a 10th Planet, even before we were finishers, when we were just training at Tiger Showman's and shit like that. So it was really cool to give those guys their black belt there. That was really awesome. We also, 10 Planet Long Island has been open for a while. And this guy's, you know, our third black belt that we gave out, me and Jam, was to Steve Kasten from 10 Planet Long Island. And, you know, Steve is a beast. He's competed. He's tapped out. He was 4-0 Kasai, just tapping black belts, competing in all types of stuff. Got a beast crew up there, him and James, Uncle Ernie and the squad. And Chris Shigoli and everybody. So really like the 10 Planet Long Island guys. Those guys are the man. And it was really epic to give, you know, Steve his black belt. So shout out to those guys. Also, 10th Planet Marshall Way MMA. Well, Marshall Way MMA, we were able to grant those dudes with Jason and Jason, who have been following us since the gate, just trying to level up, you know, just coming for information. You know, both purple belts under us. And Double Jason's and Randy and everybody over at their squad. Tom's been teaching over there and everything. So I love all those guys. I can't say enough about all the people around here that we've surrounded ourselves with, which is really awesome. And not just surrounded ourselves with, but came to us, you know, even like Eric Strausser and Lauren and their whole crew, like, love those guys. And then now Ray Ray and CeCe opened up 10th Planet New York, which is, they're crazy. Those two are fucking crazy, like, moving across the country to New York. They're gangsters. They're just like, you know what? We're going 100% for it. I was rolling with Ray Ray the other day, you know, really pumped up. So yeah, I'm just really excited about everybody, and we have so much stuff. Oh, and how about 10th Planet Miami just getting going now? But, you know, Gabe's been down there for a while now. We're also able to give Gabe his black belt. He was our second black belt. So that was really sick. So man, it's just so cool. Like, the times, it just shit went crazy. I can't even explain it. you know, from where we started, like just being at 10th Planet Allentown and having a year like this. And just like, you know, not everything, you know, I'm not really going over the negative things that happened this year to me personally, but, you know, and there were a few things, I'm sure, like I can't think of any off the top of my hand, which is really good. And, you know, I feel super blessed, but I'm sure there were things that happened that I wasn't happy with. But, you know, just to see the progression from where we were to now is just insane to me. And I just feel so blessed and so, you know, pumped to be a part of this, man. That's why I kind of why I work so hard, you know, because I want to provide for my fam. But then also, like, you know, the squad, you know, and everybody that's relying on me and stuff, like, it's just really fun to be a part, man. Like 2019, competing wise. And, you know, that was just the black belts and hanging out, my wife and stuff, and all the new, you know, the guys who are just starting out like us on the come up, you know, 10th Planet Woodbridge, Miami, Allentown, Long Island, New York, you know, and all the other extended fam. You know, like I said, I'm really pumped for all those guys, man. Like, we're just going to, anybody needs any help with shit like that, those guys that are listening to this, man, which you should be listening to this, hit me up, man. Don't feel bad. Like, just talk to me and we'll figure out what's going on. So. We also ran two we had the finishers open 3 and we had 2 finishers, 9 and 10, which is awesome. 9 was, I think, the women's one, which was really epic. Katarina Leon Vench, won the women's one, a couple of super fights, finishers 10, Alan Sanchez, Grace Gundrum, who was just, they just talked about her as being one of the, if not the top prospect in sub only game today. So I know just, you know, somebody wrote that shit, but it's cool, man. It's cool that someone respects her like that, because, you know, she didn't always get that respect, and it's still tough to kind of get her in some matches and stuff like that. So I'm kind of, you know, pushing her out there and trying to get her to wherever. She's got a match coming up against Trinity Pun at the finishers 11, the tournament I'm competing at. So really excited about that. I think I talked about that already. Dude, I learned Wim Hof in 2019. What the hell? I did the Wim Hof breathing thing and like, that was insane. So like, I know how to do a little meditation breathing. I'm going to get Joey Haas, shout out to him, to come back out here and do another breathing thing. But you know, it's like, it's nuts, man. Like, I didn't meet Wim Hof, but he's got videos of him and Wim Hof chilling. And it's crazy because I would look at Wim Hof and on the video when he first came out, me and Dan watched him and I was like, wow, this is really cool. I'd love to get into that, man. Like cryolab and all this stuff. And then all of a sudden, bam, like Joey gets hooked up with him and the whole Tony Robbins thing. Next, you know, I'm me and Kat and Hillary and JM and the whole squad's doing ice baths at the school, doing breathing techniques like a bunch of freaking monks, dude. It was sick. I'm going to have him come back and do round 2. And I think even if you don't have experience with it, you can still do it. So pumped for that. That was nuts. I also left the country in 2019. I will be in 2020, I do believe, already early in the season, if you will. Because I'll talk about that in a little bit, but we went to Japan. Like, Grace has gotten me so many goddamn opportunities and got me into stuff. It's been really insane. And one of the things, she was chosen by Eddie Bravo himself to be on the 10th Planet Quintet team. Sorry, I just gotta fix my posture, my back. I was sitting like all hunched over, like the Hunchback of Notre Dame. But Eddie chose Grace to be on the team, and that was what a big opportunity from him. And man, she almost twisted the first girl, and then she went to a draw with Rikako Yuasa, which is 4-time, you know, world champ in jiu-jitsu. So that was epic. Grace's confidence is high, you know. So, and getting us, man, the Japan trip was nuts, dude. Just being over in other countries is pretty insane. And yeah, so Thor actually has a match coming up against Adam Wierzynski. Which is, he's a, you know, IBJJF champion. I'm pretty sure he was in ADCC. I'm gonna have to really study up on this dude. And that's in London, and it's, odds are that I'm gonna go to that. So really excited about that. And yeah, I want to get out there and go, you know, watch Thor compete and the whole nine. So, man, big matchup for Thor. It's a Grapple Fest title match. So stepping right into a title match, just like your boy when he first started. And that's really sick, dude. Thor is a beast, ranked number 4 in the world, and, you know, bringing me to that. Like, there's so, and obviously so many of these things, like, you know, I could have talked about my Colorado trip with my wife for an hour, but I don't want to talk about each individual thing. I just kind of wanted to highlight some stuff. You know, Japan, obviously, there's so many stories from there, so many different things, but, you know, I don't want to just rant and rave about Japan. It was cool. You know what I mean? It was definitely cool. But the plane ride, like going to England or London is only like 6 or 7 hours. So that's not that bad. But going to California, which we did a couple of times, I think, in 2019. I can't remember how many times. Maybe three or four, probably. Let's see. Renee won the high rollers. Sick, right? Something that I'm sure he's wanted to do. And since the high rollers came out, I tried to be in it. But that was when I had that really bad staph infection. And he went out there. He killed it. Subbing dudes. Won a lot of prizes from the high rollers guys, if you will, which was really cool. And another time we were in California was for ADCC. And I talked about length about the ADCC trip. And man, Thor getting me an opportunity to go there and help coach at ADCC is epic. You know, sitting next to Eddie Bravo, you know, watching the matches go down while JM was coaching was just, it was nuts, man. It was like one of the, you're getting to the pinnacle of the sport there, which, you know, I've watched since I was young. I was watching martial arts since I knew about ADCC. I remember just chilling in when I was broke as shit and, you know, out on my ass, and I was chilling in my boy's unfinished basement on a mattress on the floor, and I was just watching ADCC matches. And then to be there, you know, maybe 6 years later or 7 years later with a guy that started with us, you know, just had limited wrestling, you know, high school wrestling, but was good enough to be a college wrestler. And he just trained with us and listened to what we said and just so happens to be, you know, one of the hardest working guys I know, gets us an opportunity to go to the biggest dance in the world. And I studied everybody. I mean, you know, Thor ended up getting fourth, and what an epic performance, tapping Rustam and stuff. He's a legend. He's in BJJ Heroes and stuff now, and he's still only like 26 years old. So let that sink in. And that stings, don't it? When you're like, you know, 30 something like me, and this dude's like 26, that shit stings, don't it? You know? So pumped about that. Because we're going to go to London for Thor, and now I'm sure he's going to be invited back to the next ADCC, and he's teaching class, and he's killing it, man. So Beast Mode Squad, Thor. And let's see what else. Let me look down the list. I competed a couple of times. My two best competitions by far was one a loss and one a win. The loss came to Joao Meow. And I feel like I did pretty good against him. And, you know, obviously everybody knows the Meow brothers. And getting an opportunity to go against Joao was pretty epic. And thank the guys from Rise Invitation for letting me do that and get me on, even though nobody really wanted that match. And I'm excited about it because I was in there, you know, going back and forth with, you know, a really good guy. It went almost 6 minutes. Got heel hooked. But I was getting out of all of his leg attacks, and you know, he wasn't taking my back or anything like that and blowing off my leg or climbing up my back or anything weird. I was keeping him off me. I was doing a good job trying to pass, I feel, the best I could do. You know, I'm not JT Torres or Gary Tonin or anything like that. And I'm pretty sure, you know, nobody passes his guard. So I was just trying to get on the neck any way possible. Well, I didn't even come close. I didn't even sniff the neck, dude. And yeah, I think the main reason why I got leg locked in that one is because I just put him in, he put me in honey hole, and I just honey sticked him, and then I you know, put the leg across, so I had the inside heel hook, and his leg felt like rubber, so I was like, you know what, whatever, and then he crossed my legs, and then I just, you know, I didn't have the escape on deck, and he got me, so, you know, shout out to Joao Meow, but I tried to kill him, so kill or be killed, that's what Nate Diaz, my boy, says. You know, kill or be killed, dog. And that's what I'm trying to do. I'm going out there and I'm slanging bombs, and I'm, you know, I'm trying to tap people out. That's what I'm going to try to do at this tournament. That's why I'm trying to make sure my cardio is up. I was on a bike this morning and stuff, and I'm going to just try to push the pace if I can, you know, and that's what I want to be able to do, even though I'm an old man. And probably my best match was a fight to win. Shout out to Seth Daniels, flew me out to Ohio to fight this guy who sells a whole ton of tickets out there. And you know, Tom DeBlast, Black Belt, And we were going at it, and I was trying to stay. Well, I knew he was going to try to, you know, he was even dressed like Gordon Ryan, so I knew he was going to try to leg lock me. So I just tried to stay away from the legs, stay away from the legs. He stood up on a single on me. I went for a heel hook on him, and then I got back up, and then eventually he went for something. He went and tried to, like, snatch up my head in a guillotine, and that's a bad idea because I've been working on my arm triangle. And if I get your arm stuck in there, if you're my weight or a little bit smaller, carayo mi boa, I'm probably going to get that arm triangle. You know, some guys are just going to beast out of it. And if I'm tired, you know, I'm not going to be able to finish it. You know, like I had Bryant in a freaking arm triangle today. He just beasted out of it. I was like, okay. So, but, you know, I'm going to give it 100% horsepower, everything I got, and just crash the car on it and just, you know, go for everything in a competition. And I had like a weird position too. I had like a top half guard and I just gunned it and ended up getting the side, the correct angle on it, and toasted him. And then he didn't tap. He kind of tapped. He Brazil tapped. He gave me like a doo-doo and it like wasn't good enough. So I was like, all right, keep it. And then the ref broke it up and he passed out. So that was cool. You know, I feel bad for him because he got to see that video a bunch of times when I posted it. But I mean, you shouldn't have passed out. I'm not going to pass out. I'm going to tap out, like, unless, you know, my arm gets stuck and I can't tap or something like that. But it's just tap. You don't want to go out. But if you do go out in your shield, that's also pretty gangster. You're just like, you know what? Fuck it. I'm going out. So that's funny, too. And I did do that. My second ever MMA fight, you know, I thought I was a good grappler. You know, I was a better stand-up guy. You know, I've been posting some of my old KOs, but, you know, I got taken down and I rolled the guy over. And as I was rolling him over from side control in a total muscle move, he just put me in a triangle. He's actually a black belt under John Donahue right now. He doesn't compete or anything anymore, but he was back in the day. And yeah, he triangled the piss out of me and then I just didn't tap. So I'm an idiot, but, you know, my dad was really pissed off at me. And after that, like, I was like, you know what? I didn't like the feeling of falling asleep and then waking up. So I was like, and also I heard that, and I don't know if this is true, and it doesn't really make that much sense now that I'm thinking about it, but, or maybe it does, because I have no idea how the passing out works, but they say if you get passed out all the time, then your body thinks, like, when it gets in a situation where it's getting airflow restricted, its shut off to protect itself is to pass out. So I don't know if that makes any sense. So it would make it easier every time someone puts you in a choke, you will pass out sooner. So I don't want that to happen. So I'm going to just tap before, especially in class or something like that. But like I said, I've seen good people just be in a guillotine or something, just be like, you know what? Not tapping. And then they didn't tap. So interesting. And I think that was pretty much it. Like, those were the big highlights of my year. You know, a lot of other stuff. And not just like, I'm not just looking for like big highlights, even though milestone accomplishments are really cool when it comes to, you know, a career or, yeah, for like, you know, for your career or for whatever you're involved in, if you want that kind of stuff. But, you know, really, I'm just proud most of all of my, you know, my family and, you know, being able to help provide for, you know, my wife, and I consider my two dogs my family, and, you know, my dad and my mom are good, and my grandmother, and, you know, everybody like that, my wife's family, like, just, you know, not that, like, I'm just, you know, I'm most proud of, like, that, like, my family, you know, and then my extended family at the school, all the really cool people that I know, and, you know, just the little things that really means a lot to you, you know, when you look back and you're like, wow, like, you know, there's so much stuff people have done for us that gets overlooked. Because you can't, you know, even though we post everything on Instagram and Facebook, you can't post everything. Like, I a million different things that people have done for me, or, you know, went out of limb for me, or like given me an opportunity. And that's why I try to do the same thing back to people. I'm trying to pump the school up as much as possible and make as much money as we can, you know, in a good way, not in like a rip off way. You know, we're not trying to rip anybody off. Like, I want to make money in a legit way, and I want to just, you know, bring as many people on along as we can, you know, that can get out of their regular job and like live their own kind of life. And that's really what I want for people, and that's what I want for my squad and my family. And that's one of the reasons why I'm working hard, and, you know, to build a little legacy here for myself and for everybody, you know, and we can all continue to grow with it and you know, every year is like, wow, like bad things happen. Like I'm sure, you know, people had, you know, people that are listeners had people in their lives pass away, you know, or people that they know, you know, that are no longer with us. And, you know, sometimes I think about that and I'm like, wow, like one day, you know, this person, you know, this is sad to think about, but one day this person won't be with us anymore. You know, so it's like so important to make those phone calls and talk to people on a daily basis. And that's like, I'm like Joey Diaz in the fact that I call people. Like texting is cool, but I can't tell what you're talking about. Plus I want to hear your voice and I want to be able to like go back and forth and hear how you're talking and stuff. And, you know, I talk to a lot of people, as many people as I can. You know, if I don't get back to your messages or something, I'm sorry. Like I'm trying my best, you know, I'm doing a lot of stuff, but I do want to, you know, just be there for people too, if I can, you know, especially my fam. So I don't know. I love you guys. I appreciate everything. And I'm going to take off now and close this piece down, but look forward to more Zach's Corners. We're at number 40. So in a whole year, I'm hoping to get up to like 75 to 100, somewhere in that range. I'm going to do some more interviews because I figured out Skype. So I'm going to get my buddy Bill Roosh on. Love to get my boy Sean Green on to talk about when he first moved out to California. And I like those motivational stories because Bill moved out to California too. So I want to get both of those guys on. I'm going to have my wife back on, talk about a lot of nutritional stuff that she's been learning. I'm going to have, you know, I want to have JM on. I want to have, you know, some guys from the school to give like a, you know, training perspective. And, you know, now that I can phone call people, who knows, I'll call somebody. I haven't even started using any of my connects yet and calling people up and talking shit. So, but you know, look forward to all that in the future. And if you want to, let me give my promos real quick. If you want to see us, I believe we're going to be teaching a seminar. Oh, yeah, in 2 weeks, we're going to be down in Miami. So if you're in the Miami-Dade County area, it's actually in Pembroke Pines. Come see me and JM at the grand opening of 10th Planet Miami. We'll have some more stuff to update. And yeah, it's going to be dope. And then also we're going to, like I said, more dates to update for seminars and all that stuff. BJJ Fanatics, our latest DVD isn't out yet, but if you don't have the first one, go back, buy the first one. Use the promo code 10PBethlehem if you haven't bought the DVD yet. You can go to shopfinishers.com. That's has all of our gear up there. And be patient. Read the stuff. Some of the stuff that you buy takes like a month and a half to come in because made in the USA. It's made in the USA and it's made in you know, in Texas, and it's sewn at one place and printed at another place. And a lot of work goes into it. So that rash guard has some tender love and care put into it before you get it and wear it. And people are always like, oh man, it takes a month and a half. Come on, dog. I'm like, oh really? A month and a half? Come on, dog. That's what a guy said to me. Come on, dog. I wanted to punch him through the computadora. I was so pissed. I was like, dude, what do you mean? I was like, what are you going to quit in a month and a half, bro? You'll be fine. All right. You'll just be hype. It'll be like Christmas. You don't even realize. I like when I order shit sometimes and it takes a while to come in because then it's like Christmas. You don't even know you ordered a package. You know, I remember one dude, I forget who it was, might have been not to sell him out, but Marky Mark said some nights when he's hanging out and he has a few too many drinks, he would just go on and buy shit. And then a couple of days later, I didn't remember buying it and it would just show up in the mail and he'd be like, oh, Merry Christmas. So I always remember that. Also, too, a lot of people have been asking what type of sneakers that three people asked me what type of sneakers that I'm wearing. And I have a pair of Vans, all blacked out, jet blacked out Vans that I rock. I have some Merrells, but my main ones that I don't wear them that often. I just got a pair of new ones. Thanks to one of my students, Levi, gave me a $50 gift card to Amazon. Shout out to little Levi. He's a boss, got a real good triangle. And he got me that gift card. And with that gift card, I bought Onitsuka Tigers. Now, everybody looks at him and goes, those are Asics. And I go, no, they're Onitsuka Tigers. But I'm pretty sure Asics owns that. I'm pretty sure. So technically, yes, they're Asics, but they have a different logo on it. So I like to be weird, but they're cool. They're really cool. They're like more flat shoes. And I'm going to get a pair actually to lift in, but these are more for just walking around and stunting on fools. So check them out, Onitsuka Tigers. But I hope you had a great 2019. And if you didn't, if you feel like it was a loss, then, you know, guess what? And not every year is great. And fuck it, move on to the next one. 2020 is a new one. Let's start making some new memories now and some new, you know, building some new shit and really putting to work stuff that you thought, you know, you weren't going to be able to do. But really, as corny as all those sayings are, you do only got one life. And if you're trying to make a move, you know, you don't have to do it like a maniac and just go out and lose your job and blah, blah, blah. But start strategically making moves to get out of the system. Buy as many guns as possible, canned food, and train jujitsu. I love you guys. Zach's Corner Podcast. We out this beyond. Thanks for listening, and thanks to our sponsor, Fuji Sports. If you guys don't know about Fuji, they've been in business in the jujitsu, judo, martial arts business since the beginning of time. And they're our current sponsor. They sponsor Thor, they sponsor Grace, and they sponsor Finishers Enterprises. So if you've never checked out Fuji before, go to fujisports.com. They got all types of gear, gi, no gi, judo. They got lifestyle stuff. They got hoodies. They got stuff to clean the mats. And they also work great with BJJ Fanatics, which we actually have a DVD out right now. So if you go to bjjfanatics.com, search 10 Planet Jiu-Jitsu, or search Zach Maslany, JM Holland, and the 10 Planet Fundamentals come up. And you can buy a DVD and watch us teach some moves. So shout out to Fuji. Also, not to mention, if you're looking for mats and you want to make your school look great and you want to take your squad to the next level, then why are you training on puzzle mats, dog? Chew doing. Get those Fuji mats. Holler your boy. I'll hook you up with the right people, and we'll get you all set up. So whether you're looking for gear, mats, DVDs, moves, we got you covered. FujiSports.com, BJJFanatics.com. Shout out to your boy. This podcast is also brought to you guys by shopfinishers.com. That's pretty much where you can get all of our gear. You can get our Cruise Combat custom rash guards, the red one, fire red, the North Carolina blue, or you can get the OD green. We're about to drop some new shirts. That's your home for Finisher TV stuff. You can actually buy tickets on there to the Finishers 10. If you want, you can get, I'm going to be releasing a bucket hat real soon, but we got some top designers, M85 Designs, Mike Mons. We got Shark Face Apparel, my boy Bryce throwing their stuff up. You can get 10P Allentown stuff. You can get 10P Miami stuff. You can get stickers. You can get 10P Miami flip-flops. We're going to be selling everything. So always check out shopfinishers.com, and that has all your needs. You can link to it from our website too. If you go to finishersmma.com, you can just click on shop right there and get all the swag that you need. So shopfinishers.com. It's your boy.
Are you interested in starting your own podcast but have no idea what to do? Maybe you already have the equipment you think you'll need, but don't have the time or resources to produce the podcast yourself. Whether you're in the market for a producer to take over an existing show, or you want to start a whole new podcast, PRM Podcast Productions is for you. We do everything from helping you get your show started to editing, producing, uploading, managing, promoting, and much more. We offer various plans and levels of editing, as well as many additional options to choose from. We also offer voiceover and transcription services, and can supply male, female, or kids voices for ads, promos, intros, outros, and more. If you want to know more or see our other shows we've produced, go to prmpodcastproductions.com or click on the link in the show notes. Anyone referred to us from Zach's Corner Podcast or from Finishers MMA will receive a 10% discount.